Good, all good fun.
Love
all,
him.
All good fun, we love it.
Coming up next, you're in for a real treat. We've been playing it for quite a while now here on BBC Introducing in Manchester and had a great reaction from yourselves. Fresh from supporting the Cortinas and BBC Introducing's very own Jake Bug. She is amazing. What a voice.
Yes.
It's Findlay coming up live. And let's have a little listen, a little taster, a little teaser of what you can expect. This is Findlay and her forthcoming single, Off and On.
The blood is thick, thicker than my thoughts are quick, quicker than the thoughts turn sick, sick, sicker than my temperature rising, sicker than the whites of their eyes despising me, and all my lovers that I can't disguise, and I'll never know why. Ooh, the air is clear, clearer than the taste of tears, clearer than the smell of fear, and I'm fearful for a long cold year with you. Don't you know what to do? You give me the horrors and I give you the goo that oozes, separate the scabs from the bruises. I turn my thoughts off.
BBC Introducing in Manchester, and the lady herself, who's responsible for those magnificent vocals and a rather magnificent video, Missy, if I do say so myself, looking all very sexy and glamorous. Oh,
thank you.
It's Findlay at BBC Introducing in Manchester. Now, you've been such a busy girl over the last, how long, 6 months, 12?
About 6 months, yeah.
It's
really
just been manic for you. Tell us what you've been up to.
We've done a lot of shows at the Cortinas and we're playing with them again in Castlefield Bowl on the Saturday that they're doing.
Yeah, 6th of July that is, yeah.
And yeah, we've got shows at the Ruby Lounge coming up in Manchester and the Electroworks in London, and then we're playing a bunch of festivals as well, which is going to be great.
You've been singing for quite a while, haven't you?
Yeah.
Before you kind of started taking it out to a live audience. What was it made you do that initially?
Well, I was kind of gigging acoustically on my own around Manchester, and then I thought, I don't want to be playing acoustic guitar anymore. I want to be, you know, a front woman. So I kind of disappeared for a while, got a really great band together, and then we started gigging the current lineup probably just over a year ago, and it's just kind of gone really well since then.
Just a bit. it's not down to luck either. It is down
graft.
To hard work. Well, this is the thing. People often make that mistake, don't they? It's, oh, you're in the right place at the right time. Or if a band do well, oh, it's who you know.
It's not who you know, who you blow. In other words.
Yeah. It is persistent hard work. And what's the best advice that you've had so far off some of, because you've worked with some established musicians, you mentioned the Cortinas a little bit earlier on. What's the best advice that anyone's given you that you can sort of pay it forward to, if there's a girl at home listening now who's in the same boat you were a few years ago?
Don't get too drunk before you go on stage. That's like number one. God, I don't know. Just try and have a good time, and then don't give up, because if you get to where we are now, it's amazing. So, yeah, don't give up. It is hard, but
I suppose where all the hard work starts for you as well.
Yeah, you think you've put in all the work, and then, yeah, then you've got to start from the bottom of where you've just got. Yeah, it's crazy.
Kind of on a different level, taking it further.
Yeah, definitely.
What's changed for you the most at the moment in terms of your life in general, or has anything changed really apart from what you're doing?
Well, I moved to London. That was quite a big change for me, because I was living above a chip shop before. Leo's Fish Bar.
In the Northern Quarter.
Yeah, yeah,
Northern
Street. Yeah. So yeah, moving to London was a big step, and then I don't know, just being able to play in front of loads of people is like amazing, and to be recognised by your peers as well as, just listeners, like Liam Frey from the Cortinas. I feel like he's, really taken us under his wing, and like he's really helped us out, which is amazing. And it's just been really fun to like meet new people and tour and get drunk and, yeah.
Have fun.
Have fun, exactly. That's what it's all about. Yeah.
Who in your eyes is the ultimate artist? Who would make you starstruck?
Probably your dad, my musical hero. I'd love to see David Bowie right now. He's like a huge, huge influence on me. I really want to go to the V&A exhibition, but there's no tickets until like August or something. God. Stupid. So yeah. But I'd love to see David Bowie, and I think his guitarist said they might be touring, so that would be amazing. I'd love to see David Bowie.
And being a Stockport girl, who amongst your peers do you really rate amongst Manchester musicians that are coming through the ranks at the moment?
I really love Temple Songs. They're a really great band. I saw them in London a couple of nights ago. They're amazing. I just love them. I just think they're amazing. And there's a band called Cult Country who I saw a couple of weeks ago. They're from Manchester, but again, I had to see them in London. And Francis Lung, who was in Woo Life, he's doing some solo stuff now, which is really cool. And
so you still get time to go and watch your live music?
Oh, yeah,
as well
I have
as all
to.
The hard work.
If I didn't, I'd go mad, so.
Yeah.
Nice to hear. You're going to play for us now live on BBC Introducing in Manchester. Tell us a little bit about the song that you're going to play.
This song's called Infinite, and it's the last track on the 4-track EP that we're releasing in a couple of weeks.
And I'm going to be hearing about some more live dates as well. You're doing a gig at the Ruby Lounge, which we'll hear about after we've heard you play live. It's Findlay live on BBC Introducing in Manchester.
I'm telling you, I'm leaving. I was never shy, but I would seek to hide away. Oh, I gaze and I gaze. What be the answer to the question? I live, your stakes will be mine.
here I come and give up who you are for who you could become. Snow melts to spring, long live the king, and it couldn't be over now if sooner we'd begun. But what for? I doubt we could have done much more inside these four walls and the floor. Oh, please answer when I call. We could be infinite and vulnerable, but I'll resist them on the outside, looking in, and I'm a stone because I left mistakes. I worry about it when I'm old. I thought I knew it all, but hey. And one world was not enough. Strange and wild is modern love. I'm not who I was before. So face your fears, now you're older.
Actually, really gobsmacked. That was amazing.
Thank you.
That was really good, Findlay.
Do you have to do any vocal training to keep your voice? Because you've got a really strong voice.
Smoke 20 a day and drink a lot of Stella.
Well, but you're not seriously not do any like vocal exercises.
I probably should. I know. Who's it? Tom Waits smokes 20 Marlboro Reds and then screams into a pillow for half an hour before he goes on stage.
Not advisable, kids, by the way.
Yeah, just eat lots of bananas and sparkling water. That type of thing.
Yeah. Vitamins and all that.
That was a really great performance.
Oh, thank you.
It's Findlay Live, just for you, on BBC Introducing in Manchester. And the 19th of April at the Ruby Lounge.
Yes.
That's your solo gig. And then, as you mentioned before...
And Shinies are supporting us as well.
Great.
And then with the Cortinas in July at Castlefield.
Yeah.
Findlay, thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks for having us. BBC Radio Manchester.